Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are going to be doing another back to school video because I know you guys love these and I love making them. So today we are going to be discussing how to get better grades for this upcoming school year. So I made one of these last year as well, and I kind of like to make one of these every year just because every single year my study habits develop and change most of the time for the better, and I kind of learned through trial and error what works and what doesn't. So today I'm going to be telling you guys what study habits that I used throughout my senior year of high school that really boosted up my grades from all of my other years of high school, and all of the like habits and tips that I'm going to be carrying with me into university to hopefully get good grades in university. So before we get into the video, do not forget to subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed, as well as follow me on Instagram and TikTok. Both my social medias will be up on the screen right here, as well as linked down below. And give this video a thumbs up if you want to see more back to school videos. And without further ado, let's just get right on to the video. All right, so my first tip is probably the one that helped me the most this past school year that I had never done before, but I feel like is one of the reasons my grades went up quite a bit last year, and that is rewrite your notes. So I know this sounds super tedious, and don't get me wrong, it is, but it's super helpful and always pays off in the end. So what I would do when I was in class in high school is I would just write my notes on a scrap piece of paper, because we didn't really bring laptops to school with us in high school. I mean, we were allowed them, but like nobody really did it. So I kind of just wrote down my notes on scrap pieces of paper, and then later came home from school and wrote my notes down in a notebook. But for me this year for university, I'm going to be taking my notes on my laptop when I'm actually in a lecture, because I can type faster than I can write, and then come back home and rewrite my notes in my notebook. So either way, whatever you would like to do, whichever one works for you, that's what I would do. Because the reason why this works so well is, one, immediately after learning the concept that you learned in class that day, you are going to be writing it down again, and then therefore going to commit it to memory better. Because I know when you're in class and you're learning everything so quickly, it can be really hard to memorize it in that moment. But when you're writing out your notes for the second time, you'll probably be so much more likely to memorize it. And this will help you for a couple of reasons. Because one, when you actually go to study for that test, quiz, or whatever it is, you are going to know the information so much better, and you are not going to have to study as much. And two, you'll actually understand the content that you learn better, because you'll be going over it a second time much more slowly. So while this can be really annoying to have to rewrite your notes every day for every single class, this will save you so much time in like later when you are actually going to study for your tests and stuff, because you'll already have like half the stuff memorized. And this is just such like a game changer for my studying. I definitely recommend that anybody do this. My next tip is something else that also really, really helped me this year, and it is to find outside resources outside of your teacher when you need help. Because obviously go to your teacher if you need help, but when it's 11 p.m. and you have your tests the next morning, it's not really something that you can do. So find outside resources that you can do besides ask your teacher. So for example, I had a couple of YouTube channels that had a lot of great videos on what I was learning that I followed this year. I'll put like them both on the screen right here. These were both for chem and for calculus as well, but like there's YouTube channels for literally like every subject that you can think of. So if you just search up a certain concept that you were trying to learn, or even just the subject of the class, you should be able to find some YouTube videos on it. And then if you find a good video that you actually like quite a bit, actually go to that person's channel and see if they have anything else, because that is how I was able to learn so many big concepts, because I also did not want to be bothering my teacher every 5 minutes. And obviously you can ask your teachers questions and stuff, but I didn't want to be bothering them every 5 minutes. And like I said before, you can't always ask your teacher a question. So basically, I took these resources outside of class, and honestly, just hearing it from another person's way of explaining it really helps me learn my concepts so much better. So I definitely recommend finding something like that to help you out. Okay, so this is another one that like seems obvious, but you would be surprised how many people don't do this. So if your teacher gives you practice problems, or even if your teacher doesn't give you practice problems, look in your textbook for practice problems, because most textbooks either have that little like check your understanding section, or they'll have like a practice test at the end of a chapter, anything like that. Normally there is some kind of practice problem there, and even if they are not assigned problems to you, do them. Because I know my physics teacher in grade 12, she would always give us practice problems at the end of our notes that were like based on that topic, and they weren't assigned to us to do, like she wasn't checking that we were doing them or anything, but like they were just for your understanding. And you would be surprised how little people would do them. Literally like nobody would do the practice problems. And there was times where I didn't do the practice problems either, but when I did do them, I found that I understood the concept a million times better. So even if your teacher is not assigning you anything to do, look in your textbook for practice problems. Go online and try to find practice tests and things like that. Also, when I was talking about the YouTube videos in my previous tip, most of the time those YouTube videos will do where they'll be like, okay, so here's the problem, pause the video, try it yourself, and then I'll explain it to you step by step. And even if the YouTube video doesn't do that, just pause the video on your own and do the question. So honestly, I find that that helps so much, that even if you don't want to use your textbook because maybe the solutions aren't detailed enough, I know that can sometimes be a problem. Also do that with the YouTube videos. If they put a question up on the screen, pause the video, and then usually they'll explain it out step by step. So do those practice problems. They're super helpful, and they can kind of give you an indication of where you are at and what you still need help on. And often teachers will take practice problems from the textbook and use them on their tests because they know that nobody does their practice problems from the textbooks. That's happened to me a few times before. I was like, this question was literally in my textbook, but the teachers know that like nobody's gonna do them, so then they just like take it and put it on the test. So then you might have the upper hand on an exam because you already know exactly what to do. Again, this next tip seems kind of self-explanatory, but I feel like so many of you guys, including myself actually, needs to hear this tip. Do your schoolwork earlier in the day. Don't do schoolwork at like 9 or 10 p.m. You are literally just gonna hate yourself, and it's gonna be terrible. Sometimes it's not avoidable if you have like a midterm the next day and you need to study a whole bunch that day. Obviously there's just some days where it's not avoidable, you have to study late. But if you just have like your average day of homework, don't wait to start your homework till like 7 p.m. or something. That's literally the worst possible thing that you can do, because then you're not going to be done till like 11 or 10 or midnight or whatever, and you're just going to be so upset, you're going to be tired, and you're not going to get anything done. But on the other hand, if you start your schoolwork at like 3 or 4 and then you go until 7, then you still have your evening to do whatever you want, and you'll be way happier when you're studying. You'll retain the information better, because let's be honest, when you are studying at 1 o'clock in the morning, you are retaining absolutely nothing. So you'll actually learn and retain the information better if you start studying like earlier in the day, and you won't be as miserable when you're studying either, which is just another bonus, because nobody wants to be miserable while studying. Obviously it's not a fun activity, but you want to make it as enjoyable as possible for yourself. Okay, so I know as a student there is very little free time that you do have, but if you ever do have some free time, practice some exam strategies, or even watch exam strategy videos. Because if you were like me and are terrible at multiple choice tests, so this is for you, because nothing is more frustrating than studying super hard and understanding the concepts and then doing bad on a multiple choice test. Especially with me with English, I do so bad on the multiple choice test. Literally, I do awful every time. I get so tripped up and I don't know what I'm doing. So personally for me, I have been starting to research more exam strategies and even watching videos on TikTok. There's actually a lot of academic videos on TikTok. If you are on TikTok and you know where to search, you can find them. But anyway, that's kind of besides the point. But basically, if you just find some exam strategies, like I've already found like a whole bunch, and maybe I'll make like a whole video on it. I'm not sure if that's something that you guys would want to see. Let me know. But yeah, find some exam strategies and practice them, because I mean, yes, it's great to study and it's great to try to get good grades, but if you're going to get tripped up on the tests, your grades are still not going to be good. So try to find some time, even if it's on this summer break, or even if you're, I don't know how many people are still on summer break. If you're still on summer break, this is the perfect time to do it. Or if you have a long weekend or Thanksgiving break or even Christmas break, is a great time to start doing these things. So I definitely recommend it, because it can be a game changer when you're trying to do tests. My next tip also seems a little bit obvious, but again, I feel like you all need to hear this. It is to change your mindset. You are not gonna get good grades if you think badly of yourself and your academic abilities. It doesn't matter how much you study. If you have absolutely no faith in yourself, you're not gonna do good. You're not gonna do good on the test or the essay or whatever. If you have absolutely no faith in yourself, you have to have faith in yourself and just know that things are going to work out and that you are capable of getting good grades. Even if you haven't necessarily gotten good grades in the past, you need to know that you are capable of changing your ways. So many people do it. So many people go from failing to being on the honor roll. So if they can do it, so can you. You need to have a little bit of confidence in yourself, have some self-confidence, and you'll do so much better in school. When you go into a test, you need to be telling yourself that you know you're gonna do good on that test. If you walk into a test and think, oh my gosh, I'm gonna do so bad, I'm literally gonna fail, you probably aren't going to do the greatest, even if you know the information. So if you have a good mindset, things will go so much better for you. And honestly, it is no more extra work to have a good mindset than it is to have a bad mindset. So shift your focus into having a good mindset, and honestly, you will thank yourself for it later. And my last tip is to start studying at least a week before the test. Again, you will thank me later. You might not want to start studying a week before the test because you'd be like, oh, I still have a whole week. No, start studying a week before the test because you do not want it to be 2 days before and you're studying till 1 o'clock in the morning like we talked about earlier. No, start studying a week before, and then that way you're not gonna have to study a lot with your, like, a lot in the day because you are spacing it out all over that 1 week. So please start studying in advance. It is the best possible thing that you could ever do for your grades. And I definitely encourage you to try this because it's probably the most obvious tip that I have in this video, but it is the best tip that I have in this video because it is so easy to do and will save you so much, like, anxiety and stress in the long run. Okay, so that is going to be it for today's video. I really hope that you guys enjoyed it and some of these tips and tricks and strategies can help you, hopefully, in the upcoming school year. I know a lot of you guys are starting school right about now or in the near future, so I really hope that these tips can help you. Yeah, these are definitely what I'm going to be using when I start school as well. But yeah, I hope you guys all have a great rest of your day, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye!